1,000 cases confirmed, more than twice as many as this time last year. Some pharmacies now running out of the antiviral Tamiflu. And every day, the ER here at UCLA Santa Monica is treating dozens more flu patients than last year.
ABC's Monica Gonzalez in Los Angeles. Airlines continue to play catch-up after last week's brood of a storm and the subsequent cold wave. The problem exacerbated when a water main broke and flooded terminals 4 at New York City's Kennedy Airport. Some travelers had to sit on arriving flights for an hour or more waiting for gates. ABC's Monica Escobedo among them.
I don't see anyone here died in the situation. There's one person over a loudspeaker that's trying to update people, but it's not much information coming.
The terminal has since reopened. He doesn't deny he made the statement, but former White House strategist Steve Bannon says his criticism of President Trump's son, Don Jr., was inaccurately reported. Bannon insisting he was calling a campaign meeting with suspected Russian officers. Speaking of it, it's directed at campaign manager Paul Manafort. A number of administration officials have been laughing at this. That's Florida Senator State Center, Zuma, a spy satellite for the government into orbit. Then a few minutes later, the first stage of the Falcon 9 rocket flying back and landing successfully to be used on future flights. You're listening to ABC News. Are you more than $10,000 in debt? Feel like you're on a